हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक इन द हिस्ट्री क्लास ऑफ सिक्स स्टैंडर्ड। टेक आउट योर बुक ऑफ हिस्ट्री एंड सिविक्स। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड द थ्री टॉपिक्स ऑफ द वैदिक सिविलाइजेशन, विच आर द आर्यंस, द वैदिक पीरियड, सोर्सेज ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन, अंडर विच वी डिस्कस्ड वैदिक लिटरेचर। स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर वी प्रोसीड फर्दर, I would like to take feedback of the previous topic through some questions. Number first question is, name the four Vedas. Second, write in brief about the origin of Aryans. Number third, define the term Aryavart. And the number fourth question is, discuss the Vedic literature in detail. Now, in today's class, we are going to read the topic Brahmavrata, the early Vedic period, which we will read its first feature, that is political organization. Now students, let's start reading of the lesson. Brahmavrata, the early Vedic period. The main features of the Brahmavrata or the early Vedic period or the Rig Vedic period are, so the first feature is political organization. The lowest unit of social and political organization in the Rig Vedic period was the kul or family. The head of the family was called kulap. Many families together formed a gram or village, which was under a gramani. A number of villages together formed a vis. A vis was under a vispati. Above the vis was the jan or tribe. The Rig Veda mentions the names of Panchjan, Yadavjan and Bharatjan. Each Jan was under a Rajan or king, who was the protector of the Jan or people. The whole country was called Rashtra. So students, in the Rig Vedic period, the lowest unit of social and political organization was the family, which was known as the Kul, and the head of the family was called Kulap. The lowest unit was the kul or the family, and the head of the family was kulap. The families united to make a village. Village was also known as gram, and the head of the gram was the gramani. Many grams together formed a vis. The head of the vis was known as a vispati, and the vis came under the jan or tribe. The head of the jan was a rajan or king, whose duty to protect the jan or people, and the whole country was known as Rashtra. And students, the Rig Veda mentioned the names of the three tribes, which were the Panchjan, Yadavjan and Bharatjan. Now let's read next paragraph. Monarchy was the prevailing form of government in the Rig Vedic age. The king led the people in war and was their protector. Monarchy means kingship. So monarchy is a form of government in which supreme authority is in the hands of a single person. The king acted as the army official of the people, and it was his duty to protect his people. Although kingship was hereditary, yet people could select a worthy person as their king if the situation demanded. Hereditary means inherited. Worthy means desirable. So children, hereditary means after the death of a king, the throne would be succeeded by his son, and in the absence of a son, any other relative or any other member of the king's family would be the next king. In spite of hereditary kingship was prevailed in the society in the Rig Vedic period, still people have the right to choose the worthy or capable king according to the demand or situation. Let's read next paragraph. The king was the supreme judge in all matters of justice. He could punish people but was himself above punishment. He appointed spies to gather information about people. Spy means secret agent. So, in the Rig Vedic age, the king was the highest authority in the matters of justice. He could give punishments to the criminals. The king employed secret agents to collect information about the people. So children, I hope the political organization of the Rig Vedic age is clear to you. Now let's read the sub-points of the political organization. The Rajan or king was assisted by many officials. The Purohit or the chief priest was the friend, philosopher and the king's guide. He performed many sacred rites and religious ceremonies. He also accompanied the king in the battlefield. Priest means someone who is specially trained to perform religious duties. Sacred means holy. Rites means services. Accompanied means go along with. So, the Rajan was helped by many officers. For example, the Purohit or the priest, who was the friend of the king, used to give instructions to the king and also went with the king in the field of battle to help him in war. Let's read next paragraph. The Senani was the leader of the army. The Gramani was the leader of the village who kept the king informed of the activities in his village. He also led the villagers during a war or battle. So students, the Senani was the leader of the army. He led the people of the village during the war. And the Gramani was the head of the village who provided all the information about the activities of the village to the king. Now, let's read the second point, assemblies. Although there was monarchy, yet assemblies such as the Sabha and the Samiti existed to aid and guide the king. Assembly means meeting. Existed means survived. So students, as you know, there was monarchy form of government prevailed in the Rigvedic age, but the king was not autocrat. His powers were limited by the existence of the two assemblies known as Sabha and Samiti. Let's read further. The Sabha was a council of elder members of the tribe who gave advice to the king on important issues. The Samiti was a general assembly of all the people of a tribe. The most important function of the Samiti was to elect a king. It could also re-elect a banished king. The king's autocracy was limited by the existence of the Samiti. Students, council means advisory body. Banished means dismissed. Autocracy means a system of government by one person with absolute power. So students, Sabha was an assembly of elder members of the Jan whose duty was to give advice to the king on the important issues. And all the common people of the Jan were the members of the Samiti. The king of the Jan was elected by the members of the Samiti. A dismissed king could be also re-elected by the members of the Samiti. So, although there was monarchy, but king's powers were limited by the Samiti. So students, this was the political organization of the Rigvedic age. Our today's class is over now. I hope the topic is clear to you. Now students, your homework is you have to reread today's topic. Solve the exercise number 5 on copy given at the page number 62.